supposedly. Hey, there we go. Yay! Take it away, laddie.
Hi, fangirls and fanboys. We missed you. It's another episode, and I don't even know which one, of the Electric Fan Cave on electricfeast.com. I'm Kristen Latterell, along with Corgan Vaughn, bringing you excitement levels that cannot be measured by mere mortals. So much to talk about. We are going to review some movies that we've seen recently, hopefully use actual words to describe our feelings about the Wonder Woman origin trailer, and discuss our thoughts on the upcoming, on the first pictures coming from Thor Ragnarok and Jurassic World 2, plus drop a little fan cave news on you. So buckle up, the crazy train is leaving the station.
Woo woo! That's not the sound a train makes. Woo woo.
Sure does.
Woo woo.
I'm gonna workshop it.
I'm doing well, Kristen. Thank you for asking. How are you doing?
I'm doing well as well.
Me too. Times well. Also, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood.
Yeah, it was cold, very cold and foggy here today.
Oh, was it?
Yes.
If I'm being honest with you, I went to the gym and then have not left the house since then. So
The sun came out for a teensy bit, but it's been pretty chilly all day. I should have worn something warmer. I was under the impression it was going to be warmer today.
This is like Southern California. I give people here a lot of crap for their ridiculousness about the cold. They're like, oh, I'm freezing, and it's, 75 degrees out. But I will say, this is the thing that is the worst, that you start your day wearing one thing and you can't end your day wearing the same thing because it drops and raises 35 degrees, 40 degrees over the entire day. It's ridiculous.
It's still silly
to wear a big old coat.
I think there's going to be a blizzard somewhere. Storm Stella or something. I was like, oh my gosh, it was cloudy all day. I should have worn a jacket.
It was just so cold. Yeah.
I'm going to listen to this and be like, fuck you.
Yeah, straight up. Because I do have people complaining all over my Facebook that are like, oh, snow, and my kids are home for a snow day, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, well. Life's all right. I'm doing okay.
Yeah.
I went to the beach yesterday. I went poke walking yesterday.
Nice. I rode my bike to the park in red yesterday.
Oh, so. Man. That's how a Sunday is supposed to be.
Yeah. Pretty good.
Yeah. So what are we talking about today?
I thought we would start off talking. We've been to the at least I've been to the movies a lot lately.
I know. This I is for once you're kind of outdoing me about- on the movies.
I know. I usually never go to the movies, but I've been a lot lately. So I actually went twice last week. So I went and saw Logan that day I came out, that Thursday. Then me, Corey, and producer Bree went and saw Table 19 last week. And then last Thursday, I went and saw Kong, Skull Island. So I feel like we should chat about them because I also saw Split. Logan's been
for anything.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. But yes, Logan. Yeah. Sorry, go ahead.
So we'll start with Logan. You haven't seen it yet?
No. And I'm like, it's so unlike me.
By the time we talked about this.
Yeah, I know.
That's okay.
It's really unfortunate. But
you need to go see it. It's real good.
Yeah.
I really
like it. So it's as good as everyone says it is. I mean,
it's as good as everyone says it is. Obviously, we don't want to do spoilery, so I just want to tell you, if you haven't seen it, like, you need to get in gear and go see it. And I think I'd mentioned this before when I saw the trailer, that I was actually very worried about Patrick Stewart's health. I thought he was actually sick because he plays a very good, like, old, decrepit old man in the movie. He's very believable. The whole movie, I'm like, oh, gosh.
He sold it.
You know, then, like, then I've seen an interview with him, that interview with him and Graham Norton with Hugh Jackman. I'm like, oh, he's fine. And then him, like, cuddling his dog lately has been, like, giving me new life.
And it's not even, like, his dog. It's a foster. He's fostering a dog for the ASPCA and has
I have a feeling that dog's not going anywhere.
Yeah. No, that dog's not going home. That dog lives with Patrick Stewart for sure now.
Yeah. So
if you haven't seen these, just go to his Facebook page. And he's just, showing the journey of fostering this dog. And from moment one, it's the way he talks to the dog. It's so ridiculous. Like, he talks to it
wonderful,
like Mr. Rogers, you know? It's just like, oh, hello, friend. You know, it's just like, really.
He's like, that was a lovely welcome. And I'm like,
yeah.
I'm like, well, and the cuteness is like his wife is like filming and he's like, oh, Sunny, she's here. And he's like so excited. He's like a little kid. I'm like, oh, God.
Oh, man. He's delightful.
Anyway, but that to say, anyway. Go see Logan. He's so great in it. Hugh Jackman is phenomenal. Yeah. Daphne, I forget her last name, the little girl, also great. I mean, everybody in it is great. I really enjoyed it.
Are there a lot of big names in this?
No, the little girl's not. She's the new thing, obviously. She's been like one other movie besides this. There's not. Eric LaSalle is in it, which I was very excited. Eric LaSalle! Wow. No, there's not a lot of big names in it. But if you are a 310 to Yuma fan, the remake of 310 to Yuma, it's the same director. Sort of like homage or Easter, if you call that an Easter egg or not. It's like a reference to 310 to Yuma. I missed it. I've seen the movie once and it was years ago. A friend of mine, it's like his favorite movie ever and he was like losing his ish over it. So if you like that, it's very fun. But anyway, go see it. I cried like multiple times. I'm also a weeper.
I know. I was just like, as I was getting ready for this, I was watching Sing Street for the millionth time. And as I was like watching it, I was just sitting there like sobbing because like I happened to, and like I was like, oh, I have to go record just at the moment where it's the Drive It Like You Stole It scene. I was like, and I was like, I have to go do a podcast. it's just so good.
You guys, so good. But go see it.
Go see also Logan. See Sing
Street. Yeah, go see and Logan.
Sing Street, obviously. If you haven't seen Sing Street yet, what are you doing with your life?
Get it together. Get it together, people.
Also the other big one, Kong. I have not gotten a chance to see yet either. I almost went by myself the other day, but.
Yeah. Kong is super fun. I actually had a great time. I thought it was funny. It was one of those ones, Brian and I were talking about it. We're like, they couldn't quite decide if they wanted to be like very serious or funny. And so there's a little bit where they seemed a little bit confused. Like, so there's that one part where the team kind of gets split up on the island and. Mm-hmm. One team is like very serious and the other team is like not as serious. And so you're like, I feel like, but to me, it didn't like ruin it by any means.
Right. It's just a weird balance.
Okay. Like, and then I told Corey this and producer Bree that it's not a complicated plot by any means. I mean, it's a King Kong movie.
I'll be the judge of that, Kristen.
Kong. It's not a spy movie. You should be able to follow it.
Okay. Then I'll be fine. But
you guys. Tom Hiddleston is like so attractive that it's distracting. Like, highly like, I'm actually just gonna cry thinking about how beautiful he was. I couldn't even really look at him. It was like looking at the sun because there's this mixture of him and he's like super buff and they've got him like in this like, he's tan and he's usually pale like a snowflake.
Right.
But tan and like not an. Yeah. But it looks normal, like a normal size, and he's got a gun, and he's like, there's one part where he's got like a samurai sword, and he's like, gasp, and I'm just like, what is happening? Also, Tom Hiddleston, like, you're so beautiful. Oh, you guys, I can't even really function when talking about it, because it's like, it's beyond, and it's, usually, I feel like he's low-key. He's got the weird hair, or he's, like, creepy, like, in Crimson Peak. He's always in these, like – and this is technically also a period movie because it's set in Vietnam. But he looks – he's got, like – he's wearing, like, a T-shirt the whole time and pants, whatever. Like, pretty normal clothes, not, like, weird. And his hair is, like, fine.
It's just too much. It's too much.
It's honestly – and I was telling – even the way he stands, like, he'll stand, like – on this like boat thing, and like even the way he's standing is so sexy.
Did you practice that? Like, do you have sexy pose in the mirror? Like, you're just standing there.
And then he's got that voice that's like just so like silky and wonderful. Oh, you guys, he was by far the best part. Honestly, even if you're a man and you like ladies, I think you are going to think Tom Hiddleston is the most hottest thing you've ever seen in your life. Yeah.
There's some people who just sometimes manage to make you feel things no matter what, you know?
My gosh.
Hiddles is one of those.
And then, like I said, the movie, fine. It was fun. It was a Kong action. The action scenes were very cool. King Kong was great. And he had the, like, eyes where you're like, oh, he's has feelings. Like, oh, he's like a person, but not.
But a giant
ape. I would recommend it. I think it's fun.
Yeah. I will definitely see it. I'm excited about it. Just for, like, it's one of those ones that my expectations aren't magical. It's not like Logan where I'm thinking, you know, everybody's talking about this. This is going to be a huge deal. With this one, it's more of just like, oh, well, this little.
Yeah, it was kind of like, remember when we went to see Doctor Strange and we were like, I just need like to not think about the world and what's happening in it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And it was fun. And like we came out of it, we're like, oh, that was actually a lot more fun than I thought, you know? And so I would say the same with King Kong. I wasn't looking for like a great, I don't know.
Right.
Like I said, fun.
It's just a romp. So. A good old romp.
It is a good old romp.
Okay, we did go see Table 19 with Anna Kendrick and a bunch of other people. That was one where we went into it, and I think, you know, it has a really low Rotten Tomatoes rating. I don't know who these people are, why they hate life and love and fun and hilarity, but we were crying laughing.
You guys. Like,
the whole movie.
Like, it's so good.
It's
not what you think. I thought I was prepared
for it. Surprised us.
Did you know this going in? We didn't know that the Duplass brothers wrote it.
Oh, did I know beforehand?
Yeah.
No, I didn't know until the opening credits. And then I was like, okay, now I feel really good about this.
Neither of us did. And I was... No. It's the same as when I went to go see, what's that one with Aubrey Plaza and Jake Johnson and the guy thinks he built a time machine or a
Gosh, I know. Neither of us can remember what it's called right now. If anyone knows what it is, do feel free to tell me.
It was like something about a wanted ad, something about applying. Anyway, this is a terrible. Anyway,
I was about to say Must Love Dogs. I'm like, that's not it.
Whatever it was. I was also like so shocked by that movie. I was like, this was not what I was expecting. Like, so heartwarming. Right. And it made me feel, and I was like laughing. And then there was parts where you're thing. So I'm like, I feel like I need to just see all of their movies because they just do such a good job and they get you.
I mean, I always say, you'll never watch it because it's kind of a horror movie, but their movie Creep on Netflix is just like one of the more creative horror movies that I've seen in a while. And like everything that they make so much stuff for Netflix. I usually watch it because I trust they're going to make something good. And that one was delightful. I thought it was really great. Also, Tom Riggs just commented, not with the name of the movie, which I am currently trying to find at the moment, but he said something about the fact that they're making like Kong and Godzilla into like a universe. So they somehow are supposed to connect to one another. Like,
I'd be into that.
Yeah.
Especially Tom Hiddleston's going to be in it. Like,
I didn't like Godzilla. So I don't know.
I didn't see it. So.
Oh, well, there you go. I think Aaron Taylor Johnson is kind of a waste of time as an actor. So there's that. Safety not guaranteed.
I have no opinion on him. The
movie.
Note, real quick before we move on, John C. Reilly was also another highlight in Kong.
What? And Safety Not Guaranteed was the name of that movie.
Safety Not Guaranteed. That was it.
Yes, John C. Reilly. I always love him. He looks great in the trailers. Like,
he's really great.
Clear really comic. Great. So
just great. He is just gold. Absolute gold.
So there's a lot of movies out you guys should probably be seeing. Just FYI.
Well, Split. You said Split was good. I won't see that either.
Kristen also won't see Split. But dude, I highly recommend that one. That's like classic status Shyamalan, you know, pre Lady in the Water and all that kind of stuff. And James McAvoy is great in it. And the gal who plays the lead of the three young women that he kidnaps in it is phenomenal. Good story, really creepy and yeah, I would highly recommend it. And there's like the ending of it has just like in the last few seconds, this little twist thing that I was just so upset because I saw it by myself, as I tend to do when I go see movies. And so I had no one to be like, ah, like, did you see what I just saw? So if you go see it, bring someone with you so that you can, you know, mind blown together.
And I told you, make sure you take someone to Kong so they can get the Jurassic Park reference that nobody in my theater got, and I'm still
I didn't know there was a Jurassic Park reference, so now I'm even more excited.
You'll get it.
I'm sure. It would be very strange if I didn't get a Jurassic Park reference.
Yeah, especially I have full confidence in it. I actually really need you to see it so that you can validate me.
All right, I will get on this. Thanks. Very soon.
And then another thing that wasn't actually a movie, but I think they probably could make it into one, was BBC Dad hit the
BBC Dad
airwaves this week, if you missed it. That was one of those videos that on Facebook, and someone had posted it, and it was like Emily I think had posted it.
Yeah, our friend Emily posted it.
And it was early in the day, and so I watched it, and I was like, oh, that's funny, and then didn't think much. And then by the end of the day, every single person in my timeline had posted it.
Yeah.
I mean, people were writing think pieces on it. Yeah. I was like, dear Lord, what has happened? Like,
this is why we can't have nice things. It was, so funny, like, because Emily and I were talking about this, that this is one of the more viral things that's happened in a while. Like, the last thing I can think of that was this viral was probably Chewbacca Mom.
Oh, yeah, and that was last year sometime, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's just peak saturation where every single person has seen it, you know? And if you haven't, if for some reason you have no idea, or you're listening to this 3 years from now and you're like, BBC Dad, what?
Yeah,
this guy is a professor who is being interviewed on BBC. He's an expert on Korea.
Yeah, South Korea.
South Korea. He's an expert on South Korea. Apparently very smart man. But poor like guy. All of a sudden his kids come bursting in, and it's like, it's so comical because the first one comes in like swinging her arms, just like happy as can be, like, you know, the kids at the beginning of Totoro. Yeah. So she's like, comes in just like, hey, let's go. And then the second one is in like a rolling walker thing and like just sort of scoots in.
Honestly, there was a second where I'm like, this is not real.
Yeah, like,
because that kid
can't be.
Or she, you can't tell, it's a very small baby.
It's a baby, you know.
Baby two comes like cruising in and is like, what up?
Yeah.
Like, that's me, like late to the, like, hey, I'm here too. What's up?
And the poor guy is like, doesn't know how to react. Like, he kind of tries to like push one kid back a little bit, you know, like, hey, you know, daddy's busy. But he doesn't totally acknowledge it, and he stops talking. And like the newscaster, obviously they have like a limited amount of time, so he's trying to get him to start talking again. And the poor guy's just like, I'm sorry. And then his wife comes like busting in out, like just a bat of hell, just flies in the room, like snags one child, pulls it back, snags the other one, like wiggles so back good. Out of the room, and then does this epic reach to close the door that is just so heroic. Like,
it's so funny because it's like she clearly was like peeing or had like turned around to get a glass of water, and when she turned back they were gone, they were, and she's like, oh god.
It had to have been a span of like 10 seconds that she took her eye off the ball.
Like, the first kid comes in and the next, it's like very quick. The whole video is like maybe 30 seconds. It's not a very long video.
Yeah.
Oh my God. It's so funny, and I love it because.
Oh, go ahead.
No, it's okay.
I was just going to say, long enough for the entire internet to decide that like they had like all about their relationship and like, you know, that clearly it must be abusive because, you know, she seemed scared and all this, like, guys, it's 30 seconds. Like,
okay. I didn't read any of the think pieces about it. I only watched them. And then I watched like the parody. Did you see the one where the kids, like the kid is doing it and his like brother comes in and then the dad is just like,
that one talking about Santa Claus.
Something, and I'm like, I don't even know what's happening. I'm just dying because the dad is like, they're like, him and the other kid are like falling on the ground. I was like, oh my god, so good. I watched that, and then I just kept watching all of the then just like the memes of like the one where it's like I walk into the club like the little girl, first girl coming in, or it's like all my parent like mom friends were like, you go to the bathroom for 3 seconds, and then it's like they made like a gif of just the mom like coming in and like trying to grab the kids. Oh,
it's great. And then like just to top it all off was that the poor guy, you know, is on Twitter, and so the like someone from BBC asks him like, just, do you mind if we put this up on our like our Twitter or whatever, like, do you mind if we put this online and share it, it was a funny moment. And his response was something like will it just be on Twitter or will it be available elsewhere, is this going to be one of those things that goes viral and gets weird? Oh, honey, yeah.
He doesn't know how the internet works.
It is going to go viral and get weird. Yeah. Even if they only put it on Twitter, it'll find a way. Life.
It's going to be so weird. It's going to be amazing. Don't worry. Don't worry.
So, hey, he gets to save that moment forever.
There you go.
You know?
You know? Oh, so genius. I loved it so much. Yeah, it's great. One of the many bright spots, actually, as far as I mean, I guess we'd call that sort of like pop culture if it's like a viral video. But we got some really fun things to talk to you guys about. So we're gonna start off with trailers, and obviously we're gonna start with the best trailer that's probably ever happened to trailers in the history of trailers. I'm gonna say it.
All right,
I'm saying it. I'm making that statement. You guys, I have zero chill over Wonder Woman. Like, absolute zero whatsoever. Chill. Yeah. None. I've lost it all. It's all gone.
Nothing you've said has ever been more accurate.
Like, yeah. Like, it's just gone. And I don't even care. Like, I know some people are like, I'm going to temper my expectations. I'm like, my expectations are so high. They're unrealistic at this point.
Like, really, there's no way that they can be met, but that's okay.
I think they I'm honestly like, this is one of the very few movies where my expectations are that high, and I'm not even like, it's probably not going to be as good as I think. I'm like, it's going to be as good as I think. Like, I am jumped all in. So if you guys haven't seen it, a new Wonder Woman Origins trailer, they're calling it, where it kind of gives you more of a background on Diana herself, has hit, and it's incredible. It's beautiful, and you get to go and see, like, you see like little baby Diana, and then you see her kind of growing up and training all in this, in her like beautiful island home, and it's like so wonderful. And then I've been reading all these things about, you know, that Gal Gadot's been saying about, she's like so excited about playing Wonder Woman and Diana, because she is just sort of this movie, and especially the difference between what will be well, kind of, we already saw Diana in Batman v Superman, so the difference between that Diana and then also the, oh my god, what's that movie called that's going to be with everybody?
Justice League?
Thank you! I was like, it's not the Avengers, but it's like the Avengers, but the DC version. Anyway.
I was a little worried your excitement, like, short-circuited you, and you had just, like switch.
I was like, anyway, so the difference between it, so in this Diana, in this first one, is she's like kind of naive and like still is like, oh, everything is wonderful. I mean, how could you not think that? And she grows up in this beautiful place. And it just looks so great, you guys. The action looks amazing. She looks amazing. Everything looks amazing, incredible, and wonderful. And I can barely handle it. I don't even have any better words to describe it other than like awesome, fantastical, wondrous, phenomenal.
Yeah.
I'm so excited. I'm crying again. I cried when I watched it. I cry every time because I'm so excited.
Oh, this show has no chill. It does. It looks amazing. I agree with you on all of that stuff. And I love that they've managed every single time to like show at the end of each trailer, there's always some ridiculous comedic moment. So in this one, you know, her walking into a door with her shield and sword,
shield,
you know,
and her sword.
Yeah, and you're like, oh, it's so great. And then like, I love those moments that they keep giving us too of Chris Pine and her, and how like he's always like, his instinct keeps being to protect, you know, it's the period piece again, his instinct being like, protect the lady, and she's constantly then like, nah, I'm good. Yeah, actually, I got you. good.
Yeah, so thanks, bro. You're right. I forgot about that because, right, yeah. The first trailer had my favorite moment of all time when he was like, I can't let you do this. And she's like, what I do is not up to you. I mean, she said it way cooler. When yeah. he's like, yells at her because she starts to climb out of the trench.
Yeah.
And he's like, Diana, no. And she's just like, bitch, like, I got it. It's fine. And then she like climbs out and I'm like, ah. And then this one, they like get kind of attacked in an alley for some reason. And he's like, oh, get behind me. And she's like, ah, don't worry, I got you. And I'm like,
and like deflects bullets off her arm. And you're like, dang, you girl.
Guys, I can't freaking handle it. Yeah. Oh, God, I can't breathe. Also, I feel like I'm getting super overheated.
Well, it's good. It was a cold day, apparently. So warmed you right up by talking about Wonder Woman.
You guys. Yeah.
It's how much longer do we have now till that is out?
Like June. Is that even till June?
June.
June
2nd. It's a while. June 2nd. It's coming though. It's we'll get there. And in the comic movie realm as well, we have the Thor stuff that came out in Entertainment Weekly.
Yes.
So from the other franchise, Entertainment Weekly's first picks, and we get to see like what our characters look like in this one, including Thor's new haircut.
Samson going on, huh?
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. Listen, I mean, Kristen, I know you have liked the hair. It has always bothered me. So yeah, I think it was even in this article, they were like, it was a little too Nelson circa 1990. And I was like, yeah, that's exactly. You know,
I guess I was alone. I was always into it.
Ugh, no, I hated it. So just cutting it off and like,
you know,
Taika Waititi is such a stylish man. Like, have you seen some of the other pictures from the set that have come out of like him directing and all that?
Yeah,
and
like he's in a suit.
He's in a suit in one and then another. He's like, just got like, I don't know, his outfits are just like coordinated and put together and all that. And I'm just thinking like Taika Waititi probably like was like, yeah, we're not doing this hair thing. Yeah. That's gotta go. This does not fit my aesthetic. And so everybody looks super cool in it. Like, is it Kate Blanchett?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hela. Mm-hmm.
Hela, yeah, is just like, I didn't even recognize her.
I didn't either. I forgot she was in it, actually.
Yeah, and she just looks like the cool, mysterious girl from high school or something. Like, she's just like, too much. I love it.
And then Tessa Thompson looks cool. Also, I mean, she also just looks like she could kick your ass, which I think is
she looks
probably
very
purpose. Yeah. There's a little bit of me, especially then when the Jeff Goldblum, because there's a lot of color.
Yeah, there's a ton. It's people were comparing it to Suicide Squad because there was a lot of
I'm not put off by it. I'm. Mm-hmm. It's made me a little like, huh?
Right.
What? Because. I feel like that those colors can get campy if you're not careful.
Right.
It's meant to look circusy.
Yeah, sure.
Not that and I'm wondering has to be dark, you know? It doesn't have to. I'm not saying that by any means. And so I'm sure there's a point behind it, I guess, to my point also.
Because the whole thing that they have about this is like they're in this other sort of like, not parallel universe, but like sort of alternate place, and it's full of just like crazy people, and like it's set up in such a way that Thor is actually one of the least powerful people in this area and all that. Yeah. So I'm wondering if that's kind of the aesthetic of this other, you know, world
place. And like I said, I'm not worried that they're gonna. I guess I still think they'll be able to, you know, explain it away, but out of context, I was like,
ooh, it's a lot. Yeah, especially the Goldblum pick.
Especially, and then someone I think on Twitter or something had posted like, oh, Jeff, we saw the new pictures from Thor. And he was like, no, that was just Tuesday.
I saw one that was like, oh, Jeff, I saw the makeup for the movie. What movie?
Oh, yeah, that was it. I knew I totally butchered that entire story. So I mean, we essentially told the same story, but.
Right. There you go. But yeah, it's, I mean, if you look up the picture of Jeff Goldblum from it, like it kind of reminds me of the Collector from Guardians of the Galaxy, you know, where it's just kind of like.
Yeah, a little bit, a little eccentric and.
Yeah, a little eccentric and crazy. He's got like a little lip, like paint thing going on and super weird. But I'm excited to see, you know, what that's going to be, like what it's going to be like.
And, yeah, maybe it'll be kind of like capital S. esque, like in Hunger Games. You know, the capital was always like very crazy, and you're like, oh yeah, sorry. That's one of those things. Like as I was thinking, I was like, oh, maybe it's more like it's just the world. Anyway, sorry, because I'm comparing it to like the world that we see now that has Thor. So I'm like, I guess if it's more when you said like the universe, I'm like, oh, I guess if it's kind of like the capital, then whatever. Yeah. That's where my brain went.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So maybe that's what it is. That could be fun. Could be really fun.
I'm just thinking this is going to be super fun.
People are like fighting to the death, so I can imagine they're like being a very like weird culture where they're like, we all dress weird and are crazy because we like to watch people die.
Yeah,
like,
and I remember weird cultures. That's what like Jeff Goldblum had described as being this like really hedonistic kind of character, and like, you know. So I'm like, yeah, the capital seems like the perfect kind of way of thinking about this area and why they would look like that and be so crazy. So
yeah,
I don't know. I'm excited about it. And the way like Taika Waititi talks about it, you know, like the Chris Hemsworth, we've been talking about too many Chris's and I'm having trouble keeping track. Chris Hemsworth like talks about it like it's a huge tonal shift and all that. And Taika Waititi is like, it's not that big a shift. But it's going to be different. You know, there's a little more humor in it, and it's gonna, you know, it's not gonna be the same as all the other Marvel movies, which I think is, you know, the best thing that's happening with all the ones that aren't the main, like Avengers and Captain America and everything, is that they all have different tones and feels that make it so you're not like, it's another Marvel movie, you know, and Guardians, obviously, like.
Oh, hold on, someone is coming into my office. Hi, can I? I'm recording right now. It's okay. Yeah, just give it to me tomorrow. Thanks. Could you lock that door? Okay. It's 6 o'clock at night. Why are you here?
Anyways.
Thor. After that, the end.
That happened.
And then I guess if we're keeping in the thread of what are we talking about? Comic book movies.
Yes. Also, by the way, Tom is on your side. He said Viking God equals long hair. So.
Aw, thanks, Tom.
Yeah. He's still hot
either way. So it's like I'm not super worried about it.
Yeah. I mean, come on. But anyways, you were saying with the comic movies.
So we're going to continue. We'll just do all of our
comics.
Together. We got some Deadpool stuff coming out, which is exciting. So if you've seen, I mean, actually, I guess even if you haven't seen Logan. Yeah, they have released the Deadpool like teaser thingy online. Anyway, so you got that. And then we got some kind of casting news. I don't watch Atlanta. Do you watch Atlanta?
No, I just got cable a week ago, so I have not, but I think I might have it on demand, and everybody's talking about it, so it feels like I should get on board.
And now everybody who's in it gets put in all these other movies. I mean, I guess Donald Glover was already kind of famous, sort of, because he was in that other show that people always talk about.
Community.
I don't remember what it was. Yeah, I don't watch that. Anyway, I don't know who any of these people are. But so we have. God, why don't you just tell this story? I'm.
I also have no idea how you say this girl's name. So apparently, Domino in Deadpool 2 is going to be played by Zazie Beetz. Zazie Beetz.
Zazie, like sassy. Zazie.
I'm not sure. Yeah, you added a third that I hadn't even considered. I have no idea how to say her name, but she's very pretty. And when I was a kid, I had like, funny enough, Deadpool and Domino were like a little bit of an obsession for me, which is not super appropriate for children, but my two favorite Marvel Masterpiece cards that I had in my collection were Domino and Deadpool. And I was super into them. So they've cast her, and it'll be interesting. I have not looked to see the backlash, but I'm sure there's plenty of people who are upset because she's black and Domino is not. But you know,
who cares?
Whatever. But unfortunately, what we did find out too in this article is that Deadpool has been pushed back to 2018.
Boo. So, or whatever.
Yeah. I mean, it's fine. These things go so, like, there's so many movies and things like that, and time moves pretty quickly that usually when they come out, I'm like, oh my God, I can't believe it's time now. So it's all right. I can wait.
As long as there's no trailer that's making right. me very excited,
yeah,
then I'm usually can, like, temper. I'm like, oh, okay. Like, give you once, and even like once they start giving pictures, so even now that I've seen like the first picture from Jurassic and now this and Thor Ragnarok, now I'm like, oh, now I really, really want to see these. Okay, but if they don't show me anything that's happening,
yeah, you just forget about it.
I'm like kind of annoyed at myself for following Ava DuVernay on Twitter and Instagram because all she posts are these incredible pictures from Wrinkle in Time. And I'm like, freaking A, the movie doesn't come out for like another year.
Yeah. And it looks amazing. And I'm like,
damn it. It looks super good, you guys. So I've already like been.
What?
What's happening? Oh, God.
Did you die? What's going on?
Sorry. my like playing music. Stop playing music.
It's just like, oh, God. Did someone come in to murder you?
Yeah. For a second, I was like, oh.
Creepy.
No. Okay. Yeah. Sorry, the tabs were started playing some sort of ad. I couldn't find them. I just closed them. You have to tell me what's happening. Anyway, so once if you don't see anything, so just now I'm like, okay, like now we just have characters. Fine. Right. I know, and I don't know anything about Zazie or whatever, however we see. Sorry for butchering it. I'm sure you're listening to our podcast. Yeah. And so I'm a little bit bummed. I'm like, I can't even be super pumped because I'm like, I've never seen her. I mean, I'm sure she's great because they always do such a good job. They did such a great job in the last one, so I'm sure she's great. So we'll have to wait a little bit more. I'm not super bummed that it's pushed back. We'll just wait, and I'm sure it'll be epic and great. The first one was pushed back like 8 years or something. So
I know, right? That was like never gonna be a thing. So push away, guys. You know, an extra year, we're really still pretty spoiled that we get to have Deadpool.
True.
Let's be real about it. You closed your Evernote, right?
No, I kept the Evernote open. I had the tabs for the Thor in case I wanted to refer to the pictures, and then I kept open. I had the tab for we're done talking about it, so fine.
Yeah.
But like I mentioned, we also got a first look, barely, of anything of Jurassic World 2.
Yeah. Yup.
And it's a cool picture.
It really is. I mean, it's. Like, it has kind of a Night at the Museum-y feel of it. There's, you know, a little girl standing in darkness in the middle of, like, a sort of museum-like hall of dinosaurs, you know, like dinosaur bones. And she's just, you see her from the back, and it doesn't give you a ton of anything, but it's just this sort of mysterious, kind of magical, I don't know who this girl will be, what's going on in it, but it makes me very excited.
I guess we'll see. We have nothing to go on except for they've dropped some hints that from the last movie or something, Dr. Wu said something to the effect of you won't always be the only people who make dinosaurs or something. So
yeah,
that's sort of the vibe we're getting that maybe there's like a rival.
Yeah. And Jen's got an evil, what do you call it?
I mean, the first Jurassic Park, right? That was what's his face was
John Hammond.
No, what was the fat guy's name?
Dennis Nedry, right. Dennis, so he was trying to sell it to somebody.
Never made it off the island. You know what I mean? I feel like there's always a theme. And then it's like, then in the last Jurassic World, Dr. Wu was actually working with that. God, I am struggling, you guys.
It's hard.
Kingpin.
D'Onofrio. Vincent D'Onofrio.
Your skin's coming off your bones. I'm going deep, guys. I'm going deep with the D'Onofrio. They seem to have some sort of like deal worked out, you know, with maybe Dr. Wu selling some of his ideas or splicing and all that stuff. So who knows? We don't know a ton. It's just a teaser enough to remind you that they're making it is sort of how I see it. So
you're excited about this, just so you know. Yeah, I'm stoked. It got me excited. It did its job. Yeah. I'm like, ah! I like just the idea, like hopefully that this being the first thing they put out, that like this little girl might be sort of central to the story.
Yeah, for sure.
Not since Lex have we really had that. In Jurassic
Park. Oh, movies, I really want to go watch Jurassic Park now.
I watched it yesterday, naturally. Okay. But
shockingly.
Shockingly. Yeah. So check that out. That's pretty cool looking. And then we got some other trailers that came out that I am just genuinely a little confused, mostly. So we have Atomic Blonde with Charlize Theron that, like, part of it, I'm like, I'm in. I'm totally in. And part of it, I'm like, what are we making here? So she's some sort of, what is she? I already forgot. Like,
I don't know. I think she's some sort of
ass-kicking, woman.
Or possibly a spy?
Yeah. Okay, good. It's not just me that does.
Like, they're killing British spy people.
Yeah.
I think.
And so she's very.
Want her to help them stop that, but I don't know if that's actually her job or if they're just like freelancing, hiring her. Or she used to be a spy and now she's just like a murderer.
Right.
I'm not super sure what's happening. And James McAvoy looks like some homeless guy that's helping her, but I don't know.
Yeah, there's a lot happening in this trailer. And of course, I love McAvoy, so I'm excited about that as well. You know, but the thing is, like, you're partway through this where you're just seeing her, like, kick ass and everything. You're like, yeah, this is great, cool, whatever. And then there's, like, an inexplicable, like, lesbian sex scene with her and Sofia Boutella. And that immediately goes to me, oh, so this is a movie for, like, dudes. This is a male-gazy, like, you know, like, this is an actual movie.
Even the opening scene, which was just her, like, taping a wire up her, like, naked body, I was like...
Right. Yeah, and you see, like, a shot of her naked in a bathtub, and, like,
yeah,
you know.
And I was like, okay, so she's naked the whole movie? I'm like, all right, well, I would have seen it. I don't know. Well, it wasn't even so much all of that in it. I think those, like, long action scenes and trailers don't do a lot for me because I'm too bored. So don't show me 40 seconds of action when I'm like, this has no, I don't know what's happening.
Yeah. And this starts that way with no context at all, just a long action scene.
Just her. And so, I don't know if they're trying to suck. I almost actually stopped watching it. I'm like, I'm super bored. I don't care about any of this. Because at that point, I don't care about her and what she's doing. I don't know who she is. And so I'm like, don't open your trailer like this. Like, so already I was like, meh. And then I watched the end of it and I was like, well, okay. I wasn't as stoked as I felt like everyone else was, which made me feel bad. I was like, should I be more excited about this movie?
You know, I saw it was trending on Twitter or whatever, but I haven't seen it being, like, passed around to the degree that I would expect something like this to be passed around to. So I feel like people probably are in kind of a, like, I maybe need to know more about this. Like, I don't know what to expect from it. I like, you know, the idea of her being, like, this badass woman, you know, killing dudes or whatever, not like she's killing dudes randomly, but trying to, you know, accomplish this for the government, trying to get her to stop agents from being killed. Like, that's a cool story. I'm into that. Seems like something Tom Cruise would do or something.
That sounds like something you would hate.
I don't mind these things. I just get confused by them. That's all.
Okay.
I'm just confused all the time. Yeah. I don't know. It's like, I'm trying to think, I'm like, if Tom Cruise is in something, I'll watch it. Does that count as not minding it? No, because at the end of it, I'm still like, I don't know what happened.
Yeah.
It's also why I don't like the Bourne movies, but I watch them all. I'm just some sort of masochist.
I don't understand your life.
Yeah. I don't know.
Anyway, Atomic Blonde, we're not really sure what's happening.
Yeah. And then there's another one.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then Edgar Wright.
And then there's
Wright
the new Edgar Wright.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What's it called?
It's called Baby Driver.
Baby Driver. I was going to call it Drive Baby. I was so close.
Yeah. Nope. Almost. Baby Driver. And it's Kevin Spacey and Ansel Elgort and Jamie Foxx and John Hamm and Lily James. And he essentially plays like a really good getaway driver.
Who's really young and some sort of prodigy of some form. And who has...
I think he's a driving prodigy. Isn't that it? Or... No.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know.
Anyway, whatever. So it sounds like he's gotten into sort of a bad way with Kevin Spacey's character, who sort of is like, he's got kind of a debt to pay off, but he really wants to run away with this waitress that he meets.
Yeah.
Whatever. It looks like a fun sort of action movie. Sometimes driving ones, though, can be sort of boring when they're just driving around a lot. So.
And also, it just feels like it's trying a little too hard, like, especially with, for like, his name being Baby. I'm like, ugh, that's annoying. Like, this is going to have to be our running gimmick the entire thing. And then like Lily James and the like Southern drawl, just being that real typical damsel in distress type thing. Like,
and what did I say when I even said it to you? I was like, why do all British people do this like weird Southern accent? Like, come on.
Yeah, I know. It doesn't work for me. And like, it just felt like everything was sort of pieces of other similar kinds of movies. Like putting Jamie Foxx and his sort of band of gangsters there, like that felt completely, totally different from everything else. And it's so, it doesn't feel like an Edgar Wright movie when you watch that trailer, but it could also be kind of like when the trailers for Guy from Uncle, Man from Uncle came out, and I was like, oh, Guy Ritchie doing Man from Uncle, like this doesn't look all that great. It's going to be weird and totally wrong. And then it was phenomenal. You know, sometimes those things work out. But I just watched it and I was like, there's nothing in here that really like would draw me to the theater to go see this, you know.
It's valid.
Fair enough.
I see what you're saying. I was really hung up on your Man from Uncle. I'm like, I wouldn't have used the word phenomenal to describe Man from Uncle.
I love Man from Uncle. Oh my gosh.
But that's totally fine. I was like, oh, okay.
Really?
So that's actually what's kind of distracted me from completing any kind of.
And it was like you just disappeared from me for a second.
Yeah, I was very hung up on that. I'm like, that is, I've never heard anybody use that word for that movie.
Crazy.
Which doesn't mean anything, I guess, but, or except I think maybe Breeze probably used it. I don't know. I think it kind of looks fun. I think another trailer might be a good thing for this one.
Yeah, exactly. I need more.
I also think I'm excited. I feel like Edgar Wright maybe is trying to branch out and do, cause it seems a little bit more serious than, mm-hmm. I mean, all I associate with him is the Cornetto trilogy.
Right.
And so
it's definitely not like that.
And this is definitely not like that. So I'm like, okay. Anyway, I don't know. And I think Ansel Elgort looks kind of cute and fun. I'm like, he's not dead, so dying in it. So let's get into it.
Right. It looks like he survives.
It doesn't look like he's going to. I mean, maybe he doesn't. Maybe he dies in a fire crash at the end. And I'm like, fucking A.
Oh, gosh.
This kid can't catch a break.
Technically, he did survive the last one, right? It just, you know, we got the old bait and switch. Right?
In which one?
In Fault in Our Stars. Isn't that how that worked?
He was the one that died in it, right?
Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, you're right.
Are we totally running this movie? Sorry, spoiler alert. Pretty sure he dies at the end because they want you to think she's going to.
Yeah, that's right. You think she's going to. I was thinking you thought he was the entire time. I had it backwards.
Yeah.
And then, they go see Willem Dafoe.
I mean, they did pull the bait and switch, but opposite of the way you were explaining it. So.
You see why movies have to be really simple for me here. Even something like that, I forget the main thing that happens.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I'm telling you, Kong's going to be hard for you and not for the reasons that you think. I've like been spiraling on Tom Hiddleston too for the past like 4 days.
It's nice to have him back, isn't it?
It is. I missed him.
I really missed Tom Hiddleston.
I love him.
Yeah.
Anyway. I'm done being super creepy about Hiddleston for now.
For now.
We have some super big news that we should get to.
We do have big news.
I think you should share it.
I should share it? Okay.
Yeah.
Well.
You're more articulate than me, especially today. So.
Well, fangirls and fanboys, as you know, we have been doing this show for a little over 3 years now and have enjoyed every moment of it. However, it is time that we move on. So the next episode of the Fancave, which date to be determined, will be the last episode of the Electric Fancave as you know it. However, do not dismay, because we're coming back. We're rebranding, if you will. We are just sort of moving on to the next thing. We are really excited. We're starting a new sort of podcast setup that is going to be pop culture oriented, but also about getting out and having adventures and experiencing life. And so it will be less frequent, not weekly episodes of it, but you know. What?
I'm sorry. I just totally forgot to do something last week. I just remembered. And what? I just remembered it. I'm sorry, nothing. It has nothing to do with you. I just saw something on my desk that reminded me that I totally forgot, and I've dropped the ball, and I'm totally screwed. Sorry. Continue.
Oh, cool. Clearly, we're in a position to do things like this because we're so on top of it. But no, you guys, follow us. We'll have a rebrand of the name. We're not going to, like, we're just going to change the name on social media stuff so you don't have to follow all over again and figure it out and all that. And hopefully you'll stick with us as we go on our next journey together. It should be a good time, right?
I think so. Yeah, we're super excited about it. Like I said, it's not, it'll be less. Well, I mean, we'll still be sitting here, I guess, when we record it. But it'll be less of us watching things and more of us trying to get outside of our comfort zones a little bit for part of it. And then also, I mean, we'll keep you updated on some of the other things that we're working on. But
yeah, there's a lot in the works, you guys. There's a lot in the pipeline.
Yeah, there's a lot going on. If we can, try and get have meetings. We're, like, very official. I mean, last week our meeting I mean, we had a business meeting in a bar, so super grown up. but yeah, so we're excited, and so we hope. Yeah, like Corey said, we're not going away.
We're just talking slightly differently about things.
That rhymes. It'll be a little bit of a different viewpoint, or not viewpoint, but slant on stuff and way to do it. So. We hope that you'll stick with us. If it's not your cup of tea, then we get that too. Obviously we can't fault you for that. I mean, we can. You should love us no matter what we do.
I don't understand why anyone wouldn't love us. It's just silly. But come on. You know.
but yeah, so anyway, yeah, stick with it. Help kind of bear with us as we flesh it out as we go. I don't actually hate saying that word, but I said it already. So yeah.
And we've got one more episode. I'm getting a little sad. You know, it is like
that, Corey.
It's a little bit like now that we're saying it like to other people, it feels weird.
Very sad.
Partway through this episode today, as we were talking about something, I was like, I miss this.
Honestly, when we were talking about Wonder Woman, I was like, what are we going to do? Because I have to have some sort of outlet for whatever the aftermath of that movie is.
We'll find a way. The joy. I mean,
joy explosion that will be the. That was a trick question. You guys all thought I was like changing my mind on how excited I am. I'm not.
No, just not going back on that. So yeah, that's our big thing. And we've been so happy to have you along on this journey all these years. All of you out there who talk to us, chat with us, and you know, send us tweets when you think of us because of stuff we fangirl out about, and all the guests that we've had on here and everything have been wonderful. And there's going to be great guests when we start this new venture as well. And it's going to be a real good time. So hopefully you'll join us on this, but we're really thankful that you've been here all of this time that we've been making this all these years through all the technical difficulties and ridiculousness. And weird breaks unannounced, you've been here, and we're happy about that.
Yes, thank you.
Right, so shall we sign off, Kristen?
That's it. Yes. So again, I mean, I would tell you to follow us on stuff, but it's gonna be a little short lived there for some of it.
I mean, you can still follow us because we'll just change.
And like
the
I said, we're gonna switch it over to the new thing. So go ahead and if you haven't already. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like on iTunes and YouTube. I'm like, where else are we? I forget. Who are we?
What is this show?
Who am I? I don't know. I guess I have a lot to ponder. What's left to ponder, amigo? The results are in.
Don't worry, you guys. There'll be as many Zoolander references when we switch over. It's not changing.
Not to worry. So, for this week and this show, second to last show.
Not forever.
Not forever. I'm Kristen Lateral.
I'm Corrigan Vaughn. Peace out, everybody.
Promise to be just as equally awkward as I sign off in our next thing.
Yep. Yeah.